Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel RF Design Basics. So in this lecture we are going to design a low pass filter using stub method, and for a cutoff frequency of 2 GHz, impedance 50 ohm for maximally flat response. This we are going to do for maximally flat response. That means for the Butterworth filter, and the order of filter is already given as 3, and finally we are going to implement it on a microstrip line. As we know that for maximally flat response having order n equal to 3, the element value is given as g1 equal to 1, g2 equal to 2, and g3 equal to 1, which can be calculated using the formula discussed in previous video, or you can use a table which gives all these values for different order of filters for maximally flat response. So the basic filter will be RS, then we have a series inductor, then we have a shunt capacitor, another series inductor, then we have a load resistance, and here we have a source, so L1, C2, L3. So these are the three elements low pass filter. We are going to use the Richards transformation and Kuroda identities to convert this lumped equivalent into the transmission line form, and for that we will start from the inductor element, then capacitor, and then we will apply the Kuroda identity. As we know that for given inductor from the Richard transformation, this can be transformed into a short circuited transmission line having length lambda by 8 and the characteristic impedance equal to the inductance L for the normalized value. Here we are talking about the normalized value. So for L1, L1 is 1, C2 is 2, and L3 is 1, which is given from G1, G2 and G3. So these are the normalized value. So L will be the normalized value of characteristic impedance. When we multiply with 50, we will get the actual impedance, but right now we will not multiply. Once we implement completely, then we will do the multiplication with 50 ohm. Similarly, for a capacitor, we have stated that there will be an open circuit having lambda by 8 length line, and if the capacitance is C, the characteristic impedance of this line will be 1 by C. So using this, first convert all the inductor and capacitors. In place of inductor, we are going to put a series stub. So this is a series stub which is short circuited, and the value of the characteristic impedance will be same as L. So characteristic impedance Z0 equal to 1 for this. Then we have a shunt capacitance. So shunt capacitor will be having an open circuit here, and the value of characteristic impedance will be inverse of this, so 1 by 2. Then another series inductor, so it's a series short circuited stub having length lambda by 8 for each of the element. This Z0 is 1. And then finally we have load resistance and the source resistance here and the source. Now this is by applying the Richards transformation. Now we have to convert this series stub into the shunt stub, and for that purpose we apply the Kuroda's identities. And in Kuroda's identities we have, if series inductor is there with a transmission line, this can be converted into transmission line with a shunt capacitor. Just the place of the element will change from left to right or right to left. So here, if it is the inductor is in left side, capacitor will be in the right side, and if the inductor is in the right side, capacitor will come in the left side. And Z1 and Z2 are the values of inductor impedance and transmission line impedance. In our case, we don't have any transmission line along with the series inductor. So what we will do is we will put a transmission line just before this, having value of impedance equal to the source impedance. Similarly, we will put another transmission line at right side, which will have the characteristic impedance value equal to the load impedance. So let us convert in that way, and it will become a transmission line. Here we are going to add, so I am just showing that with different color. This is the transmission line which is added, and then we have series inductor, so series stub, then we have shunt stub, open circuited, this is short circuited, then again we have series stub, and then again we will add a transmission line section, and finally this will be terminated to the load resistance. So these two transmission line has been added here, and we'll choose the value of this impedance, characteristic impedance, in such a way so that it will be matched with the source and load. So here we will choose the value of impedance as 1. This was already 1, this was half, and this was 1. This we will choose as 1. Now there is a transmission line and one series stub. So we have a transmission line and we have a series stub. So we can call Z2 equal to impedance of transmission line, so Z2 equal to 1, Z1 is equal to already 1, so you can calculate N square here, 1 plus Z2 by Z1, which is equal to 2. So this N square value can be used for converting this series stub into the shunt stub. And in next step we will do that. So in next step we will bring this to the left side, so it will become this is open circuit, then we have a transmission line section, then another stub which was already there, this is also open circuit. Similarly, in the right side also, this series stub will go into the right side of added transmission line. So here it will be open circuit, and this transmission line length which has been added will be equal to lambda by 8. This was already lambda by 8, so all the length will be lambda by 8 long now. And finally we will terminate this with the load impedance. Here already it is terminated with the source impedance, and we will complete the design. Now we will calculate the values of different section. Here Z0 was 1, so this value will be this Z0 multiplied by N square. So 1 into N square is 2. So this will have characteristic impedance 2. this one is also 1. Here also we will multiply with n square, and by multiplying with n square we will get the value of this section of transmission line. So this is also 2. Similarly, in the right side we have 2 and 2, and this was already half. Middle section was having half characteristic impedance. We can denormalize it. That means we will multiply all the impedance with 50, here RS1, RL1, and then we can finally write the solution here. So it will be, this impedance will be 50 ohm. Then we have two sections of transmission line having length lambda by 8. So 50 multiplied by 2 will be 100 ohm. This will be 100 ohm. And right side we have the load. Load value is 50 ohm. Then we are going to connect all the stubs. So this is a stub which is open circuit stub. This is another stub. This is open circuit stub, and this is also open circuit stub. The characteristic impedance of this stub will be 100 ohm, as it is 2 multiplied by 50, 100. This is half multiplied by 50, so this is 25 ohm, and this will be also 100 ohm. Here we will connect the source. So using this, we can implement it on microstrip line. For implementing on microstrip line, we have to see the impedance, different impedance. So this is 50 ohm at the source. So we will take a 50 ohm line. Let's say this is 50 ohm line. Then we have 100 ohm. 100 ohm will be narrower than the 50 ohm line. So here I am just making this as 50 ohm line. So this is a 50 ohm line, and here there will be transition, smooth transition. And for the stub, 100 ohm stub, we are going to have this type of design. Then we have 25 ohm stub. So this will be wider one. So this stub is wider one, and then finally we have the 100 ohm stub here, and we can write all the values of impedance. This is 100 ohm, this is also 100 ohm, 25 ohm and 100 ohm. And length of all the section is lambda by 8. So it is lambda by 8. This is also lambda by 8 for each of the section. Here we will have two types of wavelength, because we have two types of line. One line is having characteristic impedance 100 ohm. So these are all 100 ohm lines. Then another line which is 25 ohm. So for wavelength calculation, for 100 ohm, this wavelength will be different than wavelength of 25 ohm line. So to implement this on software using HFSS or any other full wave simulator, we have to find the wavelength of 100 ohm line as well as wavelength of 25 ohm line. So this lambda by 8 for a given frequency will be different from this lambda by 8. These two values are not going to be same for a given frequency because of its different value of wavelength. So here for 2 gigahertz, we can calculate the value of lambda 100 and lambda 25, we divide it by 8, and then we can find the dimension of different section of transmission line, and we can implement it on HFSS software. We will show how to check whether the cutoff frequency is matching with the given criteria or not in my simulation video. Thank you.